Evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is time again to hopefully build the market hall further. Please say I have enough clean stone. No, I don't. Oh dear. Oh dear. First and foremost, oops, you, I'll go back, we need, eh, that's evil, well then. Nothing I can do there, apparently. You know what? I need some coal. Ah. There. Go away. I need stone. That's just grand. That's just grand, isn't it? Well, strip mining. But first, fire! You go there. Boop. Boop. Let's make a little bit of room. So, do I have something to talk about today? Except my hirelings and A's were funny. No, that is basically right now off the list. I still have to render the video. I say render, export it. But I wanted to record Minecraft first. I will be beefed if I'm not recording right now. I hit the button. I will check after the session. If not, then scream. So, but first, stone. Pock, pock. Yes. I'll explore here. Don't need to explore further. Ah, come on. So now, let's go this way! An exciting episode awaits us! We've done a little bit of crafting. Basically building. Now we are going to... Oh gee. OG. This is bad. So many levels, it's unbelievable. No. I don't have food. Why are you doing this to me? Stop it. Lots of iron. Lots of iron. Seriously, how much iron? Okay. Apparently it goes down to half. Which is fine by me. Which is totally fine by me. Let's have some ender granite. Diorite is white. That's andesite. Which we will need to. But for now, let's delve deeper and deeper into the depths of this thing, whatever it is, of my doom. Okay, I basically actually have something to talk about. Do I really want to talk about it? It's a can of worms. I don't want to open a can of worms. But my mind says, do it! I hate your mind. I hate it with a passion right now, because do it! Just because of two videos I watched. Why mind? Why? Why do you hate me so? Well, the topic apparently now is racism. Yes, the two short videos I watched are about racism. There are two videos from the ZDF on YouTube. Yes, the German broadcasting station, the big one, is on YouTube. They basically have short videos there. Why is dirt here? I don't want dirt, I want... I want stone. I'll put those two videos in the video description. It's basically subtle racism. US American politics. Barack Obama, the first black president, but not the president for the black people, so on and so forth. Please cross here what race you are, so on and so forth. That type of thing. Are you Caucasian, Asian, Mexican, so on and so forth? Trump would have a field day with that one. Ay, ay, ay. That is another kind of worms. That is another kind of worms. But hey. Today is the day of the can of worms. The cans of worms, apparently. In Minecraft, so... Racism. First, let's be objective about it. Races. What is a race? Oh, it sounds a racist right now. So, a race is basically genetic or biological. Your outer appearance. From what nick of the woods of the world are your ancestors coming from? It can be seen, it can be measured, because not every human being has the same head. So on and so forth. That type of thing. Are your ancestors, and I don't mean the first humans, because if you do that, we are all African, if I remember correctly. But hey, I'm talking about European, Asian, again, African, but if we go further back, we are all African, so we are all the same. We are all the same, but different. Can go a little bit further. So, where was I? European, Asian, African, Native American, and Native Australian. The poles are inhabitable for, let's say, human beings in general, because it's so bloody cold there. And yes, that's that. Of course, there are subgroups of that, because eyes, so on and so forth. Basically, race is your heritage, your biological heritage, which basically means in the modern world nothing in the grand scheme of things. It means nothing. Basically, it doesn't mean anything for your, for what's inside of you. Your brain matter, your personality, your dreams and hopes, so on and so forth. Doesn't matter for that. And race doesn't mean that certain races are superior or inferior. Doesn't matter. It's literally just where is your heritage coming from? Sorry about that. Now, that's the biological side of things. Where is your heritage coming from? If you have, let's say, really dark skin or really tall, so on and so forth, basically African heritage, and yes, you are better, let's say, biological suited for the African environment, can take the heat a little bit better, I think. But if you look further up, Scandinavia, they are pale as fluff, I tell you. They need all the sun they can get. That's basically race. Because all biological things that can be traced down to your biological heritage. Jeez. Now, that's races. Now we are going to racism. Here's what I will say. Say again, it doesn't matter if you are of African, European, Asian, or Native American or Native Australian heritage. It doesn't matter at all. So, people, but let me again, but people have used these heritages to discriminate certain groups of people. Best example, Nazi Germany, yada yada yada. But it doesn't stop there. You can basically discriminate everybody and anybody. Because you just don't like the looks of them. Because you don't like the look of a specific ethnicity. Jesus, a lot of iron. And right now, I'm slightly racist against zombies because of their groaning and moaning. And because I want to eat my face. I need to put myself into a tin can. So where was I? People discriminating people because of their biological heritage. It's still a thing, it's almost everywhere. It's in politics, recently in the good old US of A, Trump. He and his Mexicans, or basically illegal immigrants. The biggest example in the past, as I said, Nazi Germany. But it doesn't stop there. It's, as I said, everywhere and still going on. There's something called neo-Nazis, there's the AfD, Alternative for Deutschland or Alternative for Germany. It's a political party, tearing itself apart, having all kinds of stupid people. Racists, for example. But hey. There also was the NPD. Nationalpartei Deutschland, I believe, was it standard for National Party for Germany. Those were openly racist. Those were openly racist. They are so right, it's unbelievable. And I don't mean right in the sense that they have the right opinion. Right-hand side. They are so right in the right-hand side shit. It's unbelievable. The AfD is everywhere. So, it's an whole other mess. But it's not just politics. It's in the bureaucracy. For example, if you are a European going with the USFA, it's in the video, in one of the videos. I want to spread misinformation right now, in that regard. Because if I do, I'm dead. Right now I'm giving an opinion. Not a fact, an opinion. Keep that in mind. So, where do we have racism 2? We have it in entertainment in general. TV series, YouTube, movies, books, games. Sometimes it's just there to differentiate people. Or give the in games the player choice. Skyrim or the Elder Scrolls in general, for example. Making the cast more diverse. Okay, that's not really racism, that's just have people. Because in, let's say, The Walking Dead, this day and age, they have people of all ethnicities everywhere, undead, dead or living. So, I would even argue that The Walking Dead could be the least racist entertainment right now, because no one wants to die. It's zombies. Could argue that The Walking Dead is racist against zombies, but hey. Could be worse. Could be worse. Lots of stone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. One more stack. One more stack should be enough. And there are scrolls. Races are basically here. Have race. Have something for your playstyle and a culture. Bam. And because it's medieval, it's more strict in the culture. Denmark can be really racist against Khajiit and Argonians. Slavery, for example. Some Nords are racist against Merse in general. And hi. Okay, there's also an anti-racist race called the Bretons. I think they're considered half elves. So that's that. We have everything for everyone. Come join us. It's fun. But yeah. But some games also have racism in them. Sometimes it's just there because, yeah, it's a thing. It's in the real world, so why not? Sometimes it's an actual political view. Which shouldn't be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 2, 5, 7. Let's make it 10. So and then, okay, next stop, next portion isn't just games in general, it can be all entertainment again. If racism is touched upon and basically explained and so on and so forth. If you can overcome the borders of racism, if you have, for example, a book and the main character is in a racist society. Let's say a Martin Luther King inspired book. where the main character is from the personality side of things, Martin Luther King inspired.
Yeah.
That basically is, let's say, something where I would say, yeah, let's have racism in it, because it dismembers it. A racist society is a dumb and frightened society. Because, as I said earlier, it's only biological. There's nothing else that is in between you and your goals. If you want a politician in an Asian country and want to be black and are black, then Jesus, go for it. It's possible. It'll be hard because it's Asia. Let's say you are a black person and want to be a politician in Japan. Let's not generalize Asia. Let's say Japan. Because I have a fairly good authority that it might be hard there. Let's make it even harder. Please, let's make you, in this example, also a woman. That will be fun. There are female politicians, there are probably also black politicians there. But gee, will you have a fun time. If you try to run for any sort of higher position there. Lots of fun indeed. And it's bright outside. Perfect. Because Japan doesn't know any better. Apparently. And that's what I mean. A racist society is a dumb and fearful society. They have the dumb part down. They're not afraid, which is good. And they are slightly xenophobic. Yes. Partially because Western culture and Japanese culture doesn't really mix well together. So that's that. But hey, could be worse. Could actually be worse. No. Now, thing is, where to put the actual hall? I envisioned there, but maybe here. It's not the long side, I can tell that much. I will have it the short side. Back to Japan and our example. In Japan there are certain role models. As everywhere. They're everywhere. Social acceptance, so on and so forth. That's a problem there. And don't worry. Women in general have it apparently harder there in politics, so. They have a lot to overcome. Jeez. But yeah, try to be a gaijin in general and female, and then try to run for political office. Fun times. Fun times, apparently. But yeah. As long as you are not discriminated, it should be fine. It can be easily overcome then. As I said, a racist society is a dumb and fragging society. Racists don't want to know. They don't. They see you, they see that you are different, and because they don't want to know, they discriminate you. Because you are not like them. If you're not like them, you are basically an alien. And that's it. You are an alien to them. If you are not like them, go away. You scare us. And then they want to control basically everything because are you one of them? This them. It's bad. They're afraid, they're dumb, they don't want to know, and they want to control. Every time you hear this country for the British, or England for the England for the English, because Brexit. I'm sorry, Speedo. I'm sorry. But, for example, England for the English, or Germany for the German. The use of A for the US Americans. Oh, that is another can of worms. Right there. The US America for the Americans. Oh, those racists are the best. They don't know that they are basically European. And basically illegal immigrants. That's why a lot of people have fun with Trump. Because if you go historical, the US American, not a Native American, is an illegal immigrant. And when Trump shouts out with illegal immigrants, ooh, every sensible person has fun with them. Because, dude, you are illegal here too. That's fun. There are a lot of people here that don't take him seriously. He's just an idiot! A racist and an idiot. Which finally goes always hand in hand. Racism and idiocy. Dumbness and racism. As I said, racists are dumb. They don't want to know. And because they are afraid, they want to control. And if you, and if they can't control, guess what? They beat shit up. And that's not good. Now. That's all the negative racism. Now we go to the fun part. The more subtle or the positive racism. Yay! Because that's there too. For example. Oh god. So far on the positive, I struggle with positive racism, it's unbelievable. Jeez. Jesus. It's actually a few years back that I thought about that, because it's interesting as well. Oh, Jesus. Please. Please make my brain work right now. I'm standing here like a racist. Don't want that. Jeez. Ah, brain. Why you do this to me? Racism. I now can't think of an example because negative racism is so overbearing. I know. I know an example. University. If the university has a quota for specified ethnicities. For example, we need to have such and such an amount of black people or Hispanics. And they give out places or basically, they take applicants only because of that. Because they are black, aka African American or Hispanics or whatever. Other than, let's say, the general populace. Then that is positive racism, because if you get one of those places and you are African or Asian and you only get this place because you are African or Asian, that's positive racism. You only got that place because of it. Because, oh, we need diversity. Yeah. But don't be racist about it. If you look only at the sheet of paper, the curriculum, and the application, you don't see him unless the curriculum has a photo. I don't know, man. But yeah, if you only go by what the applicant has done and has shown you in his application, and there shouldn't be any racism. But applications or the curriculum vitae, the CV, has a photo. And if they see, oh, it's a black person, do we have to reach the quota?
No, sir.
Okay, boom, done. Reach now?
No, sir.
Boom, 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 boom. If you get the place in the university, then good for you. You are not at fault for that. If you have a place, and only because of your skin color, it's the university's fault. It's the system's fault, not yours. And I recommend that you... Okay, I recommend that you work hard in general then, because university is tough. Oh, my friend is in university studying medicine. Gee. She studies. Amazing. And it's 12 p.m. I should end the episode soon. Oh, come on. Come down here, sweetie. Seriously, there's more. Thank you very much. Ah, so it's going down. The needles of the spruces are despawning. And I even got an example for positive racism. Yay! Scholarship based on skin type or skin color, which is a thing. It's not good, but if you got the place regardless, congratulations. They root for you. Make me proud. Show them. Show them that you are awesome. Study your brains out. Don't slack off. Like another friend of mine in university. I literally have two types of friends in university. The lazy and the studious type. That's amazing. And hopefully soon I will have two examples of the studious type there. One studying medicine, becoming a doctor. The second, my girlfriend, wants to study psychology. Yay! I root for her, but psychology, yes, it's an interesting field, but fire! I'm sorry for that. Oh god. But something somewhere is burning down. Oh Jesus. Go away, skeleton. Ow. Yes, it's a fire alarm. Done now? No! Round three! Let's have more! Yay! Ow. That actually hurts. It's a time of firsts for you on this channel. First time I talked about racism here, positive and negative. And then that. Ouch. Let's end on a positive note. Again, if you are in university or want to go to university, first, make me proud. Be the ace of everything. Show them who's boss. Second, if you want to go for it. Make me proud. And now I'm interested. Do I have any students in university in my viewership? My subscribers. If you're in university, comment down below. I want to know. What are you studying? How well is it actually going? I'm interested. I'm curious. But whatever you study, make me proud! Yes, I'm being a little father right now. Chibixene, make me proud! Make me proud. But for now, I say goodbye and sleep well.